Hello again, I'm back for Redemption Draft. The 0-1 with my blue-white deck wasn't quite satisfying enough, so here I am to try again. My opening pack has Rags Riches, which is a pretty powerful rare. I believe I first picked this in one of my other drafts here on channelfireball.com. I also like Grim Strider. I would definitely take Rags to Riches before I would take Shadowstorm Vizier. And then from the commons, really nothing too exciting. I guess Shimmerscale Drake is okay. I'm going to take Rags to Riches, and maybe with some tremendous luck, I can wheel Shadowstorm Vizier if nobody else is interested in black and blue. But Grim Strider, Shadowstorm Vizier, Shimmerscale Drake, Topkropi Skirmisher, Floodwaters, and maybe to a lesser extent, Blighted Bat are all playable cards that I could. And Laybear the Heart. They're all, yeah, lots of good blue and black that I could wheel from this pack. Predict probably the next player will take Grim Strider from that pack, but who knows? All right, this pack is awful, awful, awful. Laybear the Heart, Blighted Bat, or Hieroglyphic Illumination match the colors of my first pick. Otherwise, the best card in this pack is somehow Nefcrop Entangler. I guess I'll just take Hieroglyphic Illumination. But that's a very disappointing second pick. Well, this pack is great. Very different from my last pack. On color, on theme cards are Cryptic Serpent, Hecma Sentinels, and Wandering Death. But I think the power level difference between those and some of the other cards in the pack is high enough that I should not stick to my guns here. Enigma Drake's really strong, Compulsory Rest is really strong, and Magma Spray is really strong. I think I'm gonna take Magma Spray just as like the best, cleanest card, and then I can go any combination of the Grixis colors. Fetid Pool. That's good if I'm blue or black or both. Otherwise, I'd be looking at probably Shimmerscale Drake. Horror of the Broken Lands. Last couple picks have been, I think, pretty straightforward. And I'm still looking at any combination of the Grixis colors. Still probably most likely just black blue. The Magma Spray was just a little hiccup, but I don't have to panic and draft red. I could take Desert Sarodon here if I thought there was a really good chance I was gonna be black. Sorry, if I was gonna be red. But I think I'm most interested in Festering Mummy, which is a card that when I draft these blue-black control decks, I find that I'm often short on early defense, and Festering Mummy is one of the best cheap defensive cards if you're looking to just block on the ground and not die to, white red aggro's early rush. It's also combos pretty well with Rag since it's a creature that you can put into play, not worry about sweeping it away, and it actually allows you to kill three toughness guys. So I don't mind Festering Mummy here. Now I guess I have to decide between Desert Sarodon and Floodwaters. Guess I'll take Floodwaters since I'm more likely to be blue than red, but I don't know. I kind of want the Sarodon also. Then Pyramid of the Pantheon is a. I've never used this card, but I guess like if you really needed the mana fixing and had ways to sink late game mana, you could consider it. I'll just take Floodwaters. And another Festering Mummy. Is this my... It's not my opening pack yet. Okay, I didn't wield the Shadowstorm Vizier, which I was hoping might somehow happen. Lay Bare the Heart, Blighted Bat, Floodwaters, Tok'rop Skirmisher. Again, I'm not 100% sure what my colors are going to be, though. I didn't really see great red. Alright, another a Skirmisher. Painted Bluffs in case I want to splash. This is, oh wow, Enigma Drake. That throws a curveball here. Since I could shift into fully Grixis or into blue red, I guess I'll take it and just see what happens. Having just taken the Enigma Drake, should I take Tormenting Voice or just? I mean, the third Festering Mummy starts to lose a little bit of value, so maybe I don't need that. I don't know. This is a weird draft, hard to navigate. I don't really like Painful Lesson that much. This is very weird, this draft. I might just build a Grixis deck, who knows. Well, from this pack, in the Grixis colors, Baleful Amit is strong, and Splendid Agony is strong. I think I kind of want Splendid Agony a bit more. I'm going to be Creature Light. Not really going to have too many great sinks for my minus one counters. Festering Mummy's okay. I think just in general, Splendid Agony is a tiny bit stronger. Nothing in blue and red, so that's not really a consideration to stay away from a black card here. Here's a blue-red card, but it's not the most exciting. More interested if I was blue-red in, like, Emberhorn Minotaur or one of these blue cards. I suppose I'll just take Winds of Rebuke. It's a card I do like to have one of in my blue decks. Is there any consideration to trying to build black red? I guess that's not that big a consideration because one of my big draws to red is Enigma Drake. So I don't think I'm going to take Emberhorn Minotaur and look at like a black red beatdown deck. I'll just stick with blue black for as long as that's working for me. Okay, Horror of the Broken Lands. I like that. I like having as many of these as I can get my hands on. Maybe I can wheel Sacred Excavation. That would be nice. It would have to be pick 11. Which is a bit ambitious, but this is a relatively strong pack. Virtually every card in the pack is playable, so could happen. Interesting. Gale Strike, Merciless Javelineers. I'll take the Javelineers. I mean, again, I could just be full Grixis. I have a Painted Bluffs and a Fetid Pools. Gale Strike's pretty good, but not, like, insane or anything like that. Skirmisher or Reduce Rubble. Skirmisher. Painted Bluffs, Desert Ceridon, Battlefield Scavenger. I don't have hardly any Xert, so that's not that strong consideration. But I guess it's the Ceridon or the Painted Bluffs. And again, I have to ask the question, is there any way that I wind up with red as a main color? If so, I should be interested in the Seradon. Painted Bluffs is not that great for mana fixing and gets worse in multiples. You'd never really want to draw two copies of this card. So I guess I'll take Desert Seradon, continue to just see what happens. Still most likely to be blue-black, but I could be blue-red or Grixis. Very bizarre draft. Huh? One blue card and all green cards. Fact that Shadowstorm Vizier did not wheel is a really bad sign for me because it means somebody else at the table is drafting all the black blue cycling cards that I would normally really like. There's the Sacred Excavation. That's at least one piece of good news. So the incentives to play red right now are Enigma Drake and Magma Spray, and the incentives to play, well, that's those are the incentives to play blue-red. If I want to beat Grixis, I'd also get Merciless Javelineer. Though this is not looking to be that exciting of a card in my deck, because I need my extra lands, and I don't have that much that benefits me for discarding cards like you sometimes do in these colors. Okay. So I've opened some good stuff. Pull from Tomorrow is not a bomb, but a card that you're happy to add to your blue control decks. Very happy even. Shadowstorm Vizier is cool. Electrify if I want to be red, and then River Serpent. So we'll see if I can get lucky and get two of the cards out of this pack, but I'm going to start with Pull from Tomorrow. As of now, not planning to play red. If I was to get one more really good red card, I might try to splash. In this pack, best cards are Shimmer Scale Drake or Hecma Sentinels. Sentinels, how much cycling do I have? One, two, three, four. Yeah, not that much. The Drake's really good. One of my favorite blue commons. Trial of Knowledge is a really good card, but it's pretty late in the draft and I don't have any cartouches. I'm also a bit creature light, so I don't necessarily want to put myself in a position where I have to take cartouches. Only thing else that I'd really be interested in, though, is Hecma Sentinels. Maybe that card is good enough. Trial of Knowledge just as a standalone. I probably wouldn't play. If I got like two cartouches, it'd be great, but that would be pretty ambitious to hope for, given that we're already in pack three, pick three. I'll take Hecma Sentinels. Ooh, Shadowstorm Vizier. That's just what I want. River Serpent over Avan Initiate. For a control deck with cycling theme, I think that's a pretty straightforward pick. And now I'll take a Splendid Agony over a Cartouche and a Wander in Death. I could have had like 100 reduced to rubbles. Not that that's that appealing, but it's funny. Wander in Death is good in these kinds of decks, but I think I do need another removal spell. Gale Strike or Unburden. Take Gale Strike. Lay bare the heart over Ancient Crab. Already have some decent ground defense, and Ancient Crab's just a fairly weak card. Nice, River Serpent. And Pitiless Vizier will make my deck. So I guess scratch that red. I'm just sticking with the plan of blue and black here. Reduced to rubble. I'll side this in if I really am desperate for a counterspell. Secret of Insight. All right, so I'll have to make some cuts. This came together as definitely not an exciting deck, but functional. And I'm glad I didn't have to build some kind of train wreck three color monstrosity. This is just pretty solid example of a blue-black cycling deck, though you do, I think, want to have rares to make this kind of control deck work as good as well as you want it to work. Illusory Wrappings, I'm not that excited about. Scribe of the Mindful, not that excited about. Definitely do not have to play these Ta Crop Skirmishers either. Naga Oracle's a bit weak. But I probably will play all these expensive cards. Might not need two Floodwaters. And I want to play 17 lands. So that means I need two more cuts, I guess. The skirmishers really are quite bad. I didn't even get any cartouches. But Lay Bare the Heart's kind of bad also. I'll keep the Floodwaters. Cut a Lay Bare the Heart. The skirmishers really aren't doing what I want them to be doing. So, Lay Bare the Heart, Scribe of the Mindful, Illusory Wrappings. The Scribe of the Mindful is not getting back anything that exciting other than Pull from Tomorrow, but that's at that point it's a bit overkill. I guess I get back Sacred Excavation too, but probably a bit overkill as well. Maybe I'll play one Illusory Wrappings to deal with annoying big creature. Going to add some basic lands. Think I want a pretty even split because I do have these two Festering Mummies that I want to cast early. Just even split looks fine. And I'm gonna save my deck and I'll see you for round one.